databases seem never to be fast enough. To make you understand database performance issues, let me use an analogy. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome tonight, on my left, the database, and on the right, the application that is going to issue queries against the database. Query, 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 query. Each of the database is down for the count. There is a difference with boxing, though. When the database is down, your application is down too. That's when database administrators, performance experts and systems engineers are called to the rescue, all looking at the database and coming out with what they can to get through the next round. Not convincing? Then certainly the problem is with the box. In fact, some database-oriented machines claim truly impressive gains, factors of 10. Let's get a stronger fighter and a bigger box. Of course, the bigger box doesn't come cheap. For convenience, I'll ignore the costs of benchmarking, migration, non-regression testing, and the like. But software licenses for more powerful hardware don't come cheap either. Let's rewind the movie, and instead of checking what is getting hit, what about checking what is delivering the blows? In a December 2009 issue of The Economist, an interesting article about the unsung role of IT in the financial crisis was raising the issue of reports that were taking hours or days to run when they should have run in minutes. I can very easily show you how it's done. The guy, who knows a little SQL in the development team, writes for instance a query that converts an amount from a foreign currency. He writes a perfect, untunable query in which all the accesses are performed through primary keys. An instant query. Then, a developer who has only a very basic knowledge of SQL writes a very simple query that uses what the local guru wrote and runs the query against a 2 million row table. The function is called for each and every row. I have run this on a test machine. It didn't take hours, but 422 seconds, a little over 7 minutes. Then I completely rewrote the query, forgetting about the function. It's a reasonably complex query that requires some skills, but nothing outlandish. When I run it against the same data, I get my result in hardly more than 1 minute, 5 times faster. I've run the same queries with a more upmarket database, the kind of database that they use in banks. On the same machine as before, the query that uses the function gives a worse result than before, in spite of the state-of-the-art query optimizer. The query took more than 10 minutes to produce the result. Run the second query, and you get it in 2 seconds, an improvement by factor 350 on the same good old hardware, which ridicules the hypothetical 10 times improvement of powerful hardware. Read minutes instead of seconds, and that's how you can get the same result in 2 minutes or more than 10 hours. Whenever you issue a database query, the database server takes some time to process it. In most cases, very little time. As long as queries don't arrive faster than they can be serviced, everything is fine. When they arrive too fast, they have to stand in line and wait for necessary finite resources. Sometimes it's CPU, sometimes it's IO operations, sometimes locks on commonly used data, usually a mix of everything. It doesn't take long when lines build up before it goes from bad to worse, and performance crashes all of a sudden. And of course, the response time for the user, and the perceived performance, is the sum of the time actually spent to run the query, and of the time spent waiting. We are all familiar with waiting lines. We find them everywhere, and we all know the old supermarket dilemma. Is it better to wait behind one cart overflowing with food, or several small baskets? The problem is that each shopper takes about the same time to pay, whatever the amount. The issues are exactly the same with databases. There are cases when more hardware is the solution. But investing in your people rather than material and training them in using databases is likely to deliver much more return on investment. And sometimes, I wish that some sentences are something else than a corny slogan that looks good on a corporate website. My name is Stéphane Farou, and I am the author of The Art of SQL and Refactoring SQL Applications, both published by O'Reilly. Thank you for your attention.